Mast bumping is a hazardous event that can occur in a specific type of helicopter under certain flight conditions. A teetering helicopter rotor is one where the hub achieves the rotor flapping degree of freedom by pivoting around a central flapping hinge. The blades in a teetering helicopter are connected to spindles that allow blade pitch change. And these spindles are then attached to the rotor hub, where motion about the central flapping hinge allows both of the blades to flap. I'll change to a view from underneath looking up, and you may be able to spot a potential issue. When the blades flap, the spindles come close to the rotor mast. Mast bumping is the term that's given to spindle contact with the mast. I have a long-form video that explains why blade flapping is necessary in helicopters. Here's a quick summary. Flapping is necessary for helicopter control, and it also solves a problem called the forward flight dissymmetry of lift. So helicopters can't fly without blade flapping, but flapping must be constrained to a limited range of motion. To show this more clearly, I'll split the hub into a section view and color the mast red and the spindles blue. The amount of flapping in the animation is 12 degrees on either side of neutral. Blade flapping beyond this would result in the blue spindle contacting the red mast, and this event is called a mast bump. While that term may sound innocuous, an in-flight mast bump is very often a catastrophic event. In fact, a pilot's operating handbook for the R-44 helicopter has this to say about mast bumping. Severe in-flight mast bumping usually results in main rotor shaft separation and rotor blade contact with the fuselage. Low-G mast bumping accidents are almost always fatal. So the problem is that flapping is necessary for aircraft control, but excessive flapping can lead to catastrophic mast bumping. And this leads to the logical question, how do we constrain flapping to stay within design limits? Most aircraft are equipped with flapping stops, and this is what those stops look like on the R-44. I've colored the flapping stops yellow for clarity. But these stops offer fairly minimal protection. Typically, they only protect the mast against a low RPM, low energy contact, and these sometimes happen during startup and shutdown. During flight, flapping forces are much higher, and the flapping stops can't provide sufficient protection for the mast. But this is okay. Helicopters don't need mechanical flapping stops for safety because flapping is limited by centrifugal force on the blades. Under normal flight conditions, the balance of forces between lift and centrifugal force has a strong stabilizing effect and constrains flapping. This is how we avoid mast bumping. But there are certain out-of-the-envelope flight maneuvers that can make the aircraft susceptible to mast bumping, and we'll cover those in the next video. Thanks for watching.